Good morning, Oklahoma. Welcome to Cow-Calf Corner on SUNUP. We're going to address some things that are available to us now in terms of DNA testing and some technologies and making selection decisions that we're going to base keeping replacement heifers or bull development on, or just what we're going to develop to market at some point down the road. It's a benefit to us to capitalize on some of these technologies and know a little more about the genetic potential of some of these animals. What are the three things we can basically learn from DNA typing or submitting DNA? We can verify parentage. We can take a look at simply inherited traits that are controlled by one pair of genes at one locus. Think of things like the horn pole condition in cattle, coat color inheritance, and even some of the genetic defects that we've identified over the years. The third thing we can learn from DNA testing is just getting EPDs, or expected progeny differences, in the form of genomically enhanced EPDs, where we're taking a look at that DNA, we're identifying some genes that have got impact on the variation we see in our performance traits, be it birth weight, weaning weight, yearling weight, milk production, marbling. These are traits that we think of as being quantitative and polygenic. There's lots of genes that have an impact on those, and those genes we can identify that maybe have got a plus effect or a negative effect. We're going to identify those, and we're going to see an EPD come back in the form of a genomically enhanced EPD. It's going to have a higher accuracy, and based on the genes we find, that EPD itself is going to potentially go up or down. First step is to contact our respective breed association and order those tests. We're going to have instructions involved on how to submit that DNA sample. That can be in the form of hair, like hair follicles coming out of a tail switch. Typically, if we're thinking about young calves, we need them to be older than weaning age before we submit DNA that way. Probably the most convenient ways to do it on young calves are tissue samples, like a snip from the ear, or just a blood sample on a DNA card or a blood tube. If we have got an older sire that we have potentially collected and got semen in storage on, we can submit semen if we want to DNA type an older bull. But those would be the forms that it takes. Again, contacting a breed association and figuring out the proper method to get those tissue samples submitted to the lab. We're looking at a few weeks turnaround time, maybe 2-3 months tops from the time we'd order tests, submit the DNA, and actually obtain those results from the lab. Again, we're going to verify parentage. We're going to identify genotypes at locus where we have known genetic defects or horn pole status or coat color, and we're going to end up getting genomically enhanced EPDs that are more accurate. And because they're more accurate, they're going to improve our accuracy of selection and potentially accelerate our progress in meeting our breeding objectives. Again, these are all tools that are available to us right now as we think about maybe that second round of vaccinations on spring-born calves and having them through the chute at some point here before weaning or at weaning. All this is information that we can have in our toolbox to base selection decisions on these cattle at a very young age, that when we're talking about registered pedigreed animals that we've got a breed association to work with. Thanks for joining us this week. We'll see you next week on Cow-Calf Corner.